Hi, in this video, we will discuss sources of iron, rates of absorption, and iron deficiency. To start with, iron can be categorized as either heme or non-heme. Heme refers to iron in a heme structure, either myoglobin or hemoglobin. Heme iron is only found in animal sources. So you may think of something like beef. Heme iron has a high bioavailability and approximately a 25% rate of absorption, and there are no specific factors that influence this rate of absorption. Non-heme iron, on the other hand, is found in both animal and plant sources, so it is also going to be in beef, and then things like whole grain bread. Now, non-heme iron has a lower rate of absorption at only around 10%, but there are several factors that influence this rate. An MFP peptide factor that is found in meats like fish and poultry will actually increase rates of absorption of non-heme iron. Vitamin C will also increase rates of absorption by keeping that iron in a reduced state. And then things like phytates and fiber found in whole grains, rice, and legumes will actually decrease rates of absorption because it'll bind to the iron and it'll end up getting excreted rather than absorbed. Now, these are healthy foods that shouldn't be avoided in your diet, but it's something to think about, especially for vegetarians. When these foods are staples in their diet, they're going to have a much lower rate of absorption. And because of this, the RDA is 1 times greater for vegetarians. So I want to show you these graphs real quick at the bottom of the page. On the left, we can see non-heme rich foods actually have generally a higher total amount of iron in them, but the yellow bars are going to show the absorption rate. So in comparison to on the right, the heme iron rich foods, they're going to have lower rates of absorption even when they have a greater total amount of iron. Now, when someone's not getting enough iron, this can lead to a deficiency. So we have two types, either iron deficiency or iron deficiency anemia. The first one we'll talk about, just iron deficiency. This is not quite as severe, so it's going to be right in the middle of this chart up here. And this is when iron stores are depleted. And that is in the liver. When someone has iron deficiency, the signs and symptoms are going to be behavior and motivational changes. So they may be very unmotivated or even seem like they're being lazy. And to test iron deficiency, there are no good tests because it's extremely expensive to actually test those stores. So in the clinic, instead of running any specific tests, they're going to be just checking dietary changes and asking what they consume and how they're feeling and those kinds of things. Iron deficiency anemia is going to be on the far right side of this chart. And this is when we have depletion in addition to decreased transport and decreased hemoglobin production in the body. When someone has iron deficiency anemia, the signs and symptoms are going to be fatigue, weakness, and headaches. And that's especially when someone is trying to be physically active or they're physically stressed. To test iron deficiency anemia, we're going to do blood hemoglobin as well as blood hematocrit. And that can actually see if someone has iron deficiency anemia. All right, that is all for this video. Make sure to review the course notes on overabsorption of iron as well as daily requirements. And I will see you next time.